awesome. First time in Guelph, first time in Kanji. But you know, it's like it could be stereotypical for Canadians, but everyone's so nice. It's been like such a very comfortable and very smooth con so far. Scott's here, so Scott's an old buddy, so us together here is awesome. You know, it's always amazing. It's like, you know, one of the, I don't know, fears or whatnot for artists is always like, oh, I'm gonna go to a convention. I hope someone's there that cares anything about anything you've done, you know, in your career. So it's always great when you enter a room and it's like a bunch, and it's packed with people and everyone's, you know, happy that you're there. And then, you know, they're engaged, you're engaged, and the conversation's really awesome. Because I think for me, as excited as, you know, people are to meet me or hear some stories I would tell about my career, I'm always excited to meet a lot of the fans and also talk about things we're all interested in. So it's just great when people are engaged and we can kind of have a cool conversation, whether it be about my career or anything within the fandom world. You know, I just started doing like conventions in the last year or so. I've done some around the world just to travel to like London or Australia or something like that. And then of course I do Comic-Con every year to support whatever, Avatar or, you know, whatever's got going on at the time. But in the last year I kind of started doing cons around the country, North America. Partly through Grey DeLisle kind of pushing me to do it. She's like, you gotta do this. And the other part is really me being online and meeting fans in a new way. Growing up in the 90s and early 2000s in Hollywood, the relationship with the fan base was totally different than it is now with social media. So really just meeting fans online and kind of like building a new relationship kind of opened up the doors to like go to cons and let's, you know, I'm old school, like let's meet face to face. It's what I'm more used to. Yeah, there's a bunch of cool projects. I can assure people there are like two really cool, two different really cool projects that are like really kind of bigger, you know, name projects that I'm voicing characters in, which is cool. And then there's things that I'm, a bunch of other different things going on in front of the camera, behind the camera, writing. I wrote a play called Midnight Makeout Session that's had a few sold out nights in LA and it's getting it's getting renegotiated for a new run downtown Los Angeles, and co-producing a video game right now called Project Lotus with Leviathan Entertainment, and it's that's awesome. So it's my first time kind of diving into the gaming world, and we have a lot of special exciting news hopefully that we can release maybe by Comic-Con time. There is a Rufio project that we're working on. We're releasing a trailer for the Rufio movie this year sometime, and it's an animated feature, and I'm gonna voice the character, which is crazy. Man, so many cool, you know, the thing about this con is the amount of cosplayers here. I was saying it's gotta be the 80 or 90% of the people coming here, which is, I think, super big for a con. So that's amazing. And a bunch of, you know, I've seen a bunch of Rufios, which is always awesome. Some great artwork that I've seen. So I've, you know, I just got here last night and been able to do my panel and kind of pop into my autograph signing session. So I'm looking forward to kind of like strolling around the dealer room and the artist alley myself and meeting some of the artists and seeing what they have. Hey, what's up? This is Dante Basco, the leader of the Lost Boys and the Prince of the Fire Nation. Just saying, I'm happy to be here for the last Kanji Con. I made it to Guelph. Hope everyone had a great con and a great weekend. And, you know, love from Kanji.